Hello, everybody, and welcome back to the first... Well, we're on to the second month of the Jeff Research Division, where we have just sort of sacrificed the life of one of our Kerbals in exchange for 272 sciences, which is kind of a lot. And the question is what we're going to spend this on, because we could pick up one of these guys here and a 90-pointer, and I might do that, because I do want to have more of these scientific instruments. I don't think we need the extra solar panels for now. And I don't necessarily want to have one of these yet, although it might be a good idea to start doing probes, because we could send a probe to the moon and then return it with scientific data without having to transmit it and then not have to worry about stranding a Kerbal. That would give me a few more options as far as getting the data back. Now, the advanced flight control stuff is good. This is a much better probe head than the one that we've already got. And this advanced stabilizer is really, really important. I don't want to mess with this yet. I would like to go back and do some exploration of Kerbin later, but for now I'm more focused on the Moon and Minmus for right now. I figure we'll do Moon and Minmus, and then we'll go for exploration of Kerbin, and then we'll go further out. This is the one that I'm really intrigued by, because I'm curious to know what it's going to unlock. I think we're going to go for this one. Next logical step for rocketry technology. Boom! And it did unlock this. Okay, so yeah, this is heavy rocketry. That gives us the Rockomax Skipper liquid engine. Not the mainsail, though. I think this is a new one. Wow. Now, we do have enough to straight up unlock this right now, so... But I don't think we have the pieces. Yeah, we need to get this next. So we're gonna go with this, and that leaves us with enough to do another one. Ooh, are these... Yes, Clampotrons for space stations! And we have a storage container. I wonder if this... I'm curious to know if there's going to be anything about a space station that will be inherent to its scientific stuff, because I don't really know. Ah, there's the Mark 1 command pod. That's good. Okay, so all these are 160. We can't get any of these right now, but we did just unlock some very serious rocket engineering stuff. No mainsails, but we should be able to make a pretty big leap in the rocketry department. So that leaves us with a few available upgrades, and I think we're going to work on landing right now. So pop that down, and then that should give us access to the best lander strut. I'm really disappointed that that's all that was, though. Although this Mark 25 parachute is good... I was hoping it would unlock stuff like maybe rover tech. I don't know where rover tech is in this tree. I don't see it anywhere. Because my goal with the moon is to have a rover there that can rove different areas of the moon and then gather samples and then either transmit or return that data. All right, well, we have a lot of new parts to work with, and we're going to create a brand new moon ship. And I think we're going to continue doing attempts at manned moon landings and returns. Jebediah is the only one that's gone and come back. We did lose someone, the stupidest Kerbin in the world. We're going to go with Kirloff this time, because he's got courage and stupidity. And I think we need both. Alright, so, let's see here. We're going to have to make a new asparagus system, too. Because our last one didn't work. So let's worry about this being the return... Let's make a return ship here. Pretty happy with this. As far as the return ship goes, although we might want to do something more like this. Something with one of these guys here, and maybe a small engine like this, and then have fuel pods around it, or fuel, extra fuel sources around it. Something like this would be a really good for a thrust ratio, but then again, I forgot, we have to add, because we have to bring the scientific data back, so that's a thing, for one. Yeah, we're going to have to do another one of these annoying things. Because we do want to bring this home with us. And we'll take this antenna again, just because I think it looks awesome when it deploys. And parachutes never hurt anybody. Okay. Go with the dual radial parachute again, just in case. And actually, I might want to change this up a bit. I think I'm going to put the dual parachutes on this so we potentially don't lose it. Because I really don't want to lose that either. And yeah, that looks good. Okay, so that leaves the front of this open for its experimentation. And we also have the micro landing struts here. Those are new. They weigh significantly less than the ones we've been using, and I think they might be better for us. So, last time we had a bit much in the way of lander legs, and it probably ended up screwing us over for our return trip. But the question is do we want to use a fuel piece like this, or a bigger one for the return trip? Because I'm not sure exactly what we're going to need. We could do something like this to facilitate the return. The ISP in a vacuum is really good on this. It's just that these have so much power. I don't think it's necessary to have that many. Maybe just two. Something seems odd about that, though. I don't necessarily like that. I just don't feel good enough about the amount of fuel that we'll be taking with us. I wish there was a way to get a little bit more fuel in some sort of radial deployment around this so it wasn't so long and heavy. But we'll see. We do have more to work with as far as stuff. We're going to be making a very large asparagus system now. So this is our return ship per se. That fuel stage is all that we need for the return, and then we got the top part. Okay, that's good. Is that all the science we have to be done so far? Yeah, we got three experiments to do there, plus whatever our live Kerbin can do. You know what we could do for the return? Actually, this might be a better idea. How about this? How about we add on, instead, something like this. Where's the little one? So what we could do is this. Or not. Please? What if I say please? Does it help if I say please? Let me try it this way. Please? Yay! Okay, so it helps if you say please. Good to know. This could be useful if we added another engine down here, because this way we could have separatable either deceleration or acceleration engines. I'm not really sure which one those would fall under, but you can cap those off and make it look pretty. Or we can't. One of the two is going to happen here. Why are you being like that? Is there a reason for you to be like that? It's being super picky with me today. Don't do that. Game? Do we need to have a talk? Are we going to have a moment, game? Why? I want to put a nipple on it. I don't think there needs to be four of these either, so why don't we go with two? Three. We'll do the tripod. Tripods have never failed me before, except for all the times that they have failed me. And I really, really want to put a nipple on it, but it won't. It just doesn't want to let me. What if I did this, and then this? No, that's not going to work. Fuck. I know. Sorry, guys. I know, normally I would edit this out, but I'm not doing that shit anymore. Now watch. Now that we get this on here, it's going to snap onto this thing and not care. Because all along it knew it wanted me to have a nipple on it. Okay, so now we got three disposable booster rockets there, plus our central engine. So let's get our stages right here. That's good. We lost our parachute, though. Oh, don't. What about this one? Are you just picky? You want your old hat back? No, you don't want to wear a hat. For fuck's sake, game. Relax. I really am upset about the weight of those water, or I guess it's water or fuel or something. Alright, so when we want to leave, we'll first fire off these three, and then we'll do the other one, the central one. Okay, and then when we want to go home, it's going to be you guys. Oh, I see. I just now realized that these two, the vertical and horizontal things, had some sort of designation to help with that. Dur. Took me years to figure that one out. Okay, I'm pretty happy with this. The only thing it needs is batteries. And also, the battery cap worked pretty well last time, so... Oh, come on. For fuck's sake. Oh, my God. What? The game's just being a jerk right now. No, you can do nothing! Absolutely nothing can be done. I almost want to say screw it to these tests, because it's a little weird doing it that way. But no, we'll take it. Alright, now for the lander. Question is, how far down do those extend? Because we'll have to extend them. I'll lower these guys out a bit so that we can hopefully ensure lander leg success. Okay, that's probably a bit much, but whatever. I'm going to end up using some space tape with that anyway. Oh, wow, that may not be a bit much after all. Okay. We're doing the limbo now. Take me as low as you can go. That's going to work. It sort of looks like a penis. That's going to be our escape penis. Yay! That's what I always wanted, an escape penis. Now comes the fun part, because now we get to go big. I already put that thing on there. Now we're going to put the SAS module on here, and we're going to build a brand new asparagus system based on large parts, in theory. Although we don't have a lot of large parts to work with, we should have enough unlocked that we can sort of make do with something like this. That's very strange, but... Oh no, we don't have the large engines yet. That's another tier. I wonder if we could do this. With the poodle there, and then we could do an asparagus of these around it? Maybe. We'll try it. We'll see what it can do. Give it a run. Put it through the paces, you know? It seems like a fun plan. You know what we could do is actually maybe make a super asparagus system, because we're using these thin ones. Yeah. Okay. That's a damn rocket right there. Let's, aerodynamify them. You know, for science. I never did put any solar panels on this thing either. Kind of bouncing around all over the place, but we'll get through it. We will survive. I like that. That's going to interfere with my thingy. Okay, we'll do that, as well as we want a couple... Just, let's go with two on here. There we don't go. There we go. Okay, and we don't actually have a transfer stage here either. Let's go with something smallish. This could be excessive. The more you add to this kind of thing, the more it, ridiculous it gets, but I think... And the less efficient it gets. But I think that this is something that would be necessary. And that's starting to look like a nice, solid rocket, even though it's a bit on the crazy side. Let's see, let's put some lights on it, too. Those last lights, I was not happy with how those behaved for me. That looks pretty good. They weren't bright enough. Before we go, I also do want to test these landing gear and see if they extend to the area that I want them to. We might not even need them at all, but, you know, just in case. Alright, so let's tape this thing together. Nice and sturdy. And then wiring up the fuel pods on this guy is going to be real tricky. I'm going to tape these little fellas together. Yeah, doing the stages and the fuel stuff is going to be really funky. Let's go with... Here we go. Yeah, we'll do it in a similar manner to what we did before, except this time instead of three, there's going to be four. I think. Yes. Okay, so that's how you do it. Oh, that could be an issue. Maybe not. Yeah, I've never had an asparagus with this many pieces and this much of a central fuel tank either. This could really just be a flat-out suicide, but you never know. Sometimes you know, but usually you never know. I hope that's enough SAS for this big-ass thing. Ooh, that is a problem right there. That is a problem right there. We're going to have to lower these down so that... Yeah, that might have screwed up the piping as well. It did not screw it up, at least not overtly. It just doesn't look right there. And I'd prefer it if it looked right. And that one's not even... That one doesn't even exist. What happened there? Oh, what the fuck? Yeah, okay. We lost all of our fuel piping. Okay, so I think I got this thing all wired up and staged up correctly-ish. And this thing is kind of a monster. Let's name it. It'll be the... JRD Super Lifter Mark 1. And then I saved this section from here to here as a science lander module. Although we are going to have to do a little testing before we even leave, before we even press the go button, because I want to find out what those landing gear do. And again, we won't really know what this thing is capable of until we've shot it out into the atmosphere. Capable of standing still on the launch pad, so that's good news. Okay, those landing legs do not reach the engine ports. Or they do, but just barely. That's not good. We might have to use the other lander legs, but they're so heavy. Well, by comparison. Let me see if I can lower these lander legs a little bit. We don't need much. We could probably just straight up land it on the engine ports because it's got three of them in a line there. I think that this is actually lower than what we had before, so although that's not centered. I think that's lower. Let's try it out. We haven't had to do a lot of Mark 2s or 3s yet. Which is, I suppose, a good thing. Okay, yeah, that's a little bit lower. That'll give it a bit better stability. Okay, well, I guess now we can see what this son of a gun can do. By gun, I mean son of a penis rocket. Let's see if it can even lift itself. Well, it can definitely do that. The thing I'm afraid of is it spiraling out of control. Lift these this triple tank poodle engine up out of the atmosphere with this asparagus system, man, we'll be golden. Because that's a ton of fuel. Oh boy. Serious deceleration now. And this engine does not provide much ISP in a vacuum. Not the kind of thing that you want to use as a primary lifter. Might need some solid boosters or something. The first couple stages there are fine. I think maybe the asparagus system, or maybe we could remove one of these tanks. I think that might be a wise idea. Because, yeah, look at all that deceleration. It's not going to be enough. No. Nope, 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 nope. Who the hell was that? Was that Jeb? Did he sneak into the pilot seat? Jeb! You jerk. He took Kirlorf's Jorb. Right, let's try pulling one of these off. And I'm thinking that what we might want to do is add a real simple, just a late stage solid booster to this guy right here. So that when it's down to just these two engines, although that's going to be really high up, I guess, because of our winglet. Oops. Control Z, motherfucker. I don't want to lose my pipes. Yeah, I think... Ugh. I think if we just... Although it might force a... Oops, I never did duplicate. Yeah, if I duplicate it, it might... Yeah, it's going to force it this way. Unless we manually do it. And those won't be exactly even. Vertically mirrored. Yeah, that's not even close. That's dangerous. I'm not sure I like that. In fact, I'm pretty damn sure that I don't like that. how about instead of that, we just see how it does with just these two. We'll designate this the Mark II because we did make a pretty significant change there. And we'll maybe try solid boosters later, but for now, that'll hopefully decrease the payload enough that this asparagus will get us further. And I don't think I need to do max thrust on this one, because I think we're accelerating past the ceiling of usefulness. Jebediah, what is... Fuck, man. He's just determined. He's going on every single mission. He's the man. He wants to do it. He does not care about the rules or the regulations. Jeb is going to kick someone out of the cockpit and take it for himself. I still don't think this is going to be enough thrust to lift us once we get down to the two stages. That deceleration was much less than before, but it's still pretty significant. Well, we are getting quite a big boost out of this stage. I guess it all depends on what the final asparagus stage looks like. Got us to 200, and that's a pretty big dip. Yeah, we're never going to get up to 300 meters per second with this. That little amount of thrust with all that payload. There is a ton of fuel in this thing. Each one of these carries twice as much fuel as one of the external tanks. You know what we could do? We could use adapters to create an asparagus system that would use these engines to lift this thing. I'll have to look at the numbers for the ISP. But, yeah, this is gonna fucking fall straight down. It just doesn't... We don't have the, we don't have the central booster large enough. Let me take a look at this ISP. Okay, we got 390 in a vacuum, but only 270 at sea level. Max power 200, 220... I think if we were to do something like this, where we take one of these adapters here, and we toss a more powerful engine down here, it might give us the thrust that we need to replace this engine, although it doesn't seem all that much more. The total mass is much less, for one thing. But the maximum power is actually lower. Not by much, but still, it's lower. Yeah, I don't know. I don't think we have the parts ready to use this these large fuel tanks here. That's kind of a bummer. What if we did away with all of that and went with something much smaller? Oops. It's a little weird, but it could work. And I do kind of want to incorporate some solid boosters in this design. I think the only way we could really do that is if we were to go like this. Now, if we stage these solid boosters correctly, we could end up doing pretty well. This will be a fun experiment for the solid boosters here. I'll see if I can get these solid boosters to time along with the separation of these parts here. Alright, I've moved it up to the Mark III, and now we're using only one of these large fuel tanks, and we've got solid boosters all the way around. I've always been curious about how solid boosters would work in regards to the asparagus system, so today we're going to find out together. He's like, wee! That's not at all how that was supposed to happen. In fact, those engines are... Oh, no. What? Oh, I did the firing, but I didn't do the decoupling. Whoops. Alright, this one's gone well beyond the bizarre. Let's just see what happens, shall we? Okay, so we've got all of these inner boosters firing. We've got a couple of these solid boosters firing. We're gonna have solid fuel left. I guess I'll wait to do the next stage until the solid fuel boosters run out. It's gonna cause some problems. We're still accelerating, so there's that. Okay. Yeah, the solid fuel boosters are... It's sort of like a second ring, because this one's empty now. And the solid fuel boosters are still going. Very strange. Yeah, we're behind by quite a bit. In fact, we've got two stages that could do with losing now that are dead weight. But we're still climbing very slowly, admittedly. See, these ones are going to run out by the time they're solid boosters, so it's like a second stage for the solid boosters, I guess. I'm really curious to see what's going to happen once we get rid of this next set of solid boosters and start the gravity roll. I really genuinely don't know if this is better or worse. So far, it just is, you know? Alright, so this the liquid stage that we're on right now is dead, but... Or no, it's not. It's still going a little bit. So it sort of catches up. Okay, now the liquid stage is dead, but the solid boosters are still going, and we're still getting good thrust out of it. This actually might be a good thing. You could probably optimize this to work better than I have it. What if, the better way to do it would probably be to have the liquid boosters on the outside of the solid boosters instead of the solid boosters on the outside of the liquid boosters. That would be the way that you would want to do it. But now we've got this guy to where he wants to be. Out in... Not quite... He's not in the ISP yet, so his... Or in a vacuum yet, so his impulse is still going to be rising. It says it's 390, but it should be lower. Until we get really, really, really out into a vacuum. Curious to see what we have left once we establish an orbit around the planet. I'll go for 90,000 to 100,000 for the altitude. And then we'll see what we can get out of this guy. If we can get an orbit around Kerbin with fuel left over in this a little bit, then that'd be really great. Although I do think that we need to redo the asparagus part so that the liquid boosters on the outside of the solid boosters. And the solid boosters would be the main sail, if you will, of the ship. Alright, we're gonna have to start burning really early on this. Let's start now, because of how little thrust this guy's gonna give us. But that's okay. As long as he gets us in orbit, we'll be happy. We might be going a little too early here. Well, no, I'm going to skip ahead a little bit. All right, I did manage to get it to establish an orbit, but we had to burn off more than half of our transfer stage's fuel. So net result there is not good. But I'm curious to know how this thing is going to perform. So instead of going to the moon, we're not going to risk that. We're going to stay in orbit around here. We're just going to jettison this stage here. And then I want to see, it's just the three of these engines firing here. And that's actually giving us quite a bit of thrust and using a fairly little amount of fuel. See, if we could engineer most of the deceleration from landing to take place on the previous stage, then this would be plenty to get us out of there. And even if these are the ones that are doing the landing, we still have this entire central column of fuel. But it does make the lander awfully heavy. Well, where is that gonna... Whoops. Okay, yeah, these three thrusters are pretty strong. Let's do a decel burn. I'm pretty happy with this lander module, actually. I think it's got potential. It's just a matter of using what we have as far as our current rocket tech to get a little bit of extra oomph out of it. We'll do some experiments here, and we'll bring them home. It'll be a good chance to test the parachutes as well. Store that data. Alright, these three are out of fuel. Let's jettison them. And that still leaves us with all of this left for the return trip, which is quite a bit. Let's get this down to a stable orbit, then I'll do an EVA, get an EVA report and a crew report to store, and then we'll head back, just so we can get a little bit of extra science out of this deal. Although there'll probably be diminished returns because we've already got a bunch of them, and we probably already transmitted a bunch of them. I believe you can transmit a crew report at 100% efficiency. Think. Yeah. We'll send that. We've got the battery and solars for it. Yeah, we've already got a lot of the crew report stuff done. Okay. 190 and 80. So that leaves us safe to do a EVA. Let's get an EVA report over the ocean. We'll keep that. And hopefully we can land this thing somewhere interesting and get a soil sample we haven't got already. Whoops. Although getting back on here is apparently going to be a bit annoying. Come on. Yeah, we can get a thermometer reading while we're out. Not out here, but while we're in space as well. Although we weren't able to get one before. Let's log the temperature. Okay, perfect. We can record that and send that back. So we have data stored there, data stored here, data stored here, and let's go ahead and do a decel burn with the rest of our fuel. Plunk us down somewhere, hopefully. Whoa, we want to make sure we don't land in the water, otherwise we'll lose that, lose the data pod. Oh boy, we've got to make a decision here, and I can't quite see. How much fuel do we have left? We should have enough to be able to land on this big continent here. We do our decel burn right. There's a fairly large continent. It's tough to see because it's nighttime, but right around here. Oh, that's a pretty nice lake there. Yeah, I can't see shit. Let's do a orientate. Oh, if we want to burn the other way, and we might be out of fuel. No, we still got fuel. Yeah, let's burn it down. Man, this thing's got a lot of fuel left. Alright, that is pretty much guaranteed to get us on land. What is going on there? That lake thingy right there is really cool looking. Not going to concern myself with that. For now, let's just ride the lightning. Hopefully we'll come in over land. Get rid of that guy. Because we don't need him. I wonder if we need a, some kind of landing gear on this thing to stop it from being crushed. We'll see. Okay. Once you go this way and... pop the chute, so that's interesting. I'm going to try to let this thing ease down without snapping the chutes off. Like, I guess we're going to be landing face down. That's one way to ensure that the data on this thing gets stored, but it might also crush Jeb. He's upside down. But he likes it that way. Actually, he doesn't seem to care. For once, Jeb's not excited. And I don't know exactly where we are, but looks like just a simple grassland. We'll get a soil sample from it. If things don't explode. Hey! Okay, that's a problem. We're gonna need to be able to get back in here. Let's observe the goo here. Keep that data. Come on, I need you to flip over so that we can get back inside. I'm just gonna rock it around. Rocking around the Jebsmith tree. Oh, it's Jebsmith time tonight. Come on, Jeb. This is your job, is to randomly do things. What? I'm really concerned about our inability to get back in this thing if we get out. I don't want to get a soil sample and then lose it. Because I don't think you can recover a Kerbonaut that's not inside of a thing. I'm pretty sure they have to be in a thing. Oh, that was close. Okay, I think I got this. Ugh. Come on. I'm doing this. Oh, I got it! I got it. I mean, Jeb got it. Get your butt out of there. Dirt. We require dirt. Let's get a surface sample. Stored at. And our EVA report. Stored at. Now, we can just store the experiments in here. Hop back inside. And when we recover this, we should get quite a few experiments, even though it was a fairly failed launch. Yeah, we didn't get much science. 42 science, that's not bad. Most of that came from the temperature scan while in space and the material study while in space, because we'd never really completely recovered those. But it's back to the drawing board as far as our rocket is concerned. I'm going to make some changes off screen, and then when I come back, we can have a bit more fun with this.